The 10 Pin Bowling Show is proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.
Welcome again to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. We are watching coverage of the Sports Cover Insurance All-Star Challenge. Tonight, you're about to see the second match between Jason Walsh and Sam Cooley. And what we'll have you guys do now is just shake hands, you guys, and get straight into it. Best of luck in high scoring.
Thank you, Dennis, and welcome to all our viewers to this week's edition of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. We're covering game two of match number three in the Sports Cover Insurance All-Star Challenge for 2010. There are the scores from last week. Sam Cooley's in a big deficit. He is 78 pins behind Jason Walsh of New South Wales. Sam Cooley is first to appear on the lanes. Welcome, Brenton Davey.
Thank you, Michael. He's got a lot of ground to make up, and that's a positive start.
Great start from Sam.
Proudly wearing the green and gold. Let's have a look at this one. Nicely played, looks like a little more speed. Still using an aggressive ball. Jason Walsh, who up to this point in time is absolutely blitzing this lane condition.
Yes, before coming on to meet Sam Cooley, he defeated Australia's number one bowler, George Philingos.
Pretty convincingly too, and with form just like that.
He's playing this lane condition perfectly at the moment. Started with a 269 in this two-game aggregate. Adding 10 to that, as you can see.
Retains a 78-pin lead after one frame. Sam really needs to shoot something pretty big here, because I don't think, with the look Jason's got on this condition, that Jason's going to slow down too much.
Sam was a little bit unlucky last week. He left a lot of nine counts with the solitary turkey in the middle.
Ooh, a bit more width on that one. Definitely gave that one some room. Have a look at this one. Big angle of entry. Sliced him and diced him.
Four pin doing the job on the seven there. And he needs that little bit of luck, I think. He's coming up against a red hot Jason Walsh.
Needs every break he can lay his hands on. I mean, the reality is he's almost has to take this off the sheet, and even if he does, that might not be enough.
Now, if he was to do that, all Jason Walsh would need to shoot was a 192.
Well, Jason certainly doesn't look like slowing down either. That's a great shot right there.
Two from two from Jason Walsh.
This ball is usually just giving him a nice, controllable, arcing reaction on the lane. Giving him some area, not only inside and outside his target, but with the length of the break point. He's not having to be as precise with the length of the break point. And as a result, he's just kicking this place big time. Sam Cooley needs to keep going.
Let's hope he can. Ooh. Big sigh of relief there as he saw the pins head towards the back of the deck. Let's have another look. Ball started to travel high. And that is why he breathed a deep sigh of relief. The nine pin was the last to leave the deck.
Was every opportunity of leaving that one, but he is keeping himself in the match. It's just so important that he does that. Jason now looking to match Sam's turkey. It was a tad inside that one, Michael.
Yeah, a tad inside caused the ball to break just that little bit earlier. And as a result, you can see a four pin.
But the difference is with this particular piece of equipment he's using being a little bit more of a control piece, the fact that he was inside, it didn't snap hard through the beak. This ball tends to have a very even arcing reaction, and it just gives him a little more margin for error. Out with the polyester spare ball straight at it.
Well done from Jason. He's got two strikes and a spare. Jason Walsh would only require 223 for a shutout then, and he would progress on to next week.
Well, he's not on that pace yet. If Sam can keep going, well, anything could happen. But Sam must keep striking.
If he can keep piling on the pressure and keep putting on the strikes, you just never know what can happen in a two-game aggregate.
Now we're just going down to Dennis.
Thanks, Brendan. I'm here with Dennis Birch, who's the head mechanic and technician here for Vayner Ball and Campbelltown City Ball. How do you see the lane pattern playing for today?
No, it seems to be playing pretty good. The lanes are holding up real nice and the scores are opening up. Looks like they're going to just keep ripping them apart.
As you can understand, they only import the best into Australia, don't they?
That's it, man. That's it.
Yeah, back to you, Brendan.
A little bit of a mutual admiration society going on down there. Thanks very much, Dennis. Back to the action now. Jason looking to get back on the strike train. And he does.
Shredded the rack with that one. Nice piece of carry. Plenty of action and revolutions on the ball, and that, viewers, is the reason why we do it.
Look at that head pin. Cartwheels off the wall. Polex is a seven pin. Big strike.
Plenty of action there.
And Sam, for his four bagger, has only picked up, you know, 11 pins thus far. Another one now. And he's starting to get a little bit more back into the action.
Oh, didn't look pretty, but it went.
He's gone with a little more speed.
Oh, 5-7 just dropping like dominoes. We're going to go down briefly with Dennis, who's going to have a quick word with Sam.
I'm here with Sam Cooley, halfway through the second game. He's in the groove, relaxed, calm. How do you feel, mate?
I feel a bit like an idiot at the moment.
Is that because you're in two different colour shoes?
Partially that, but no, just wrong ball in the first game, and now all of a sudden I can carry.
Well, that's all right. It's a learning curve, mate. You're doing well. They still got a ball. Well done. Back to you, Michael.
Thanks.
Thank you for that, Dennis. And after watching Jason throw down another strike, we're going to be right back. And welcome back to the 10 Pin Bowling Show's continuing coverage of the Sports Cover Insurance All-Star Challenge from Campbelltown City Bowl. You're witnessing game two of match number three between Sam Cooley of New South Wales and Jason Walsh, also of New South Wales. Sam Cooley has the first five strikes in this two-game aggregate format. See if he can keep it going.
Anguish in the crowd, and I think anguish for Sam here. As harsh as it sounds, that's almost a shutout there. Really needed, you know, as far behind as he was on a high scoring condition like this, needed to take it off the sheet.
Yeah, that would have been fantastic. But considering Jason Walsh, even before that leave, only needed 223, it's now much less than that. Oh, hello.
Never a seven pin there when you need it, is there? That would have caused some excitement. Have a look at this. Ball jams the pin up against the pit curtain. Ejects it back hard out into the pin deck.
And folks, had there been a 7-10 split, one would say that would just about be spared. You don't see that too often.
Absolutely. Would have just about cut the head off the 7-pin with that one. That came out real hard.
One tells me Sam wasn't too impressed with a 10-pin lead.
Took a little bit of anger out, and I think Jason Walsh now.
Uh-oh, look
out.
Got
the messenger. Oh.
Almost. And
someone yelled out short pin from the grandstand. I don't know about short pin. These pins look fairly new, and I reckon they've got pretty flat bases.
Maybe broomstick from the head tech.
Needed the black painted pool cue, I think, for that one.
Now Jason to spare up his 10-pin leave. And I'll tell you what, had that pin fallen, it's probably the last thing Sam Cooley needed to see.
For sure. It's a 57-pin deficit now for Sam Cooley, and he's running out of frames.
But credit to him, he's cut it back. He started this game 78 behind. So he's taken a little bit off of it.
You see, though, he's been mentally kicking himself for not using this ball in the previous match. And it's a horrible feeling when that happens. When you're too late making the adjustment, especially when you've got a reaction in an area like that.
Yeah, he's looking really good now.
Yeah, just that horrible thought going to your mind, you idiot, or words to that effect, anyway. He just wasn't carrying anything like that last week.
No, he looks so relaxed now throwing the shot. You can see the script going through his head that he should have made that move sooner. But you're not to know, are you? With two games, you've got 20 frames to make good.
Two-game match, you get a few practice balls before your match, and you've got to make a very quick decision.
Jason Walsh having the huge advantage of, you know, having a couple of games on this condition beforehand. It's, yeah, you're really at a loss to explain how to make that move in such a short time.
A couple of very high-scoring matches too, which is the big thing. He's just really been very, very dominant thus far. Hasn't looked like losing. Sam now really just trying his level best to give himself some kind of a chance. But he's going to need help from Jason.
We gave that plenty of room. Lots of room. The ball didn't check up. As you can see, a very, very light hit in the 1-3 pocket.
From that much width, basically the ball had too many boards to cover. And basically it rolled out in about the last 10 feet. And that was the reason it didn't get all the way back to the head pin. He'll go back though, shoot for the spare. Unusual, he's been throwing hard and straight at them. Went the circular route that time.
Look, in the general field of play, the best way to take out the 8-pin is to throw your regular strike shot. And I think that's what he's decided to do there.
In general terms, that is the case. On some of the tougher tournament patterns, quite often you're better off going with something a little harder and straighter. But certainly on a pattern like this where the guys that, you know, have plenty of margin for error, that kind of method works very well.
Those are definitely your two schools of thought. Jason Walsh, he is tearing it up here at Campbelltown City. He's got a comfortable lead, and we'll be right back after the short break.
Welcome back to the 10-Pin Bowling Show, where you're watching continuing coverage of the Sports Cover Australia All-Star Challenge.
And welcome to the conclusion of this week's match. You're watching the 10-Pin Bowling Show. Match between Jason Walsh and Sam Cooley, both New South Welshmen. Jason carrying a very, very healthy lead. And we only have two frames to play.
And again, looks like the carry's just started to desert Sam a little bit here. It's a little bit too late anyway, but certainly this match has shown the kind of form that won him the Australian Masters this year.
I love that. Grins at the pins, turns around.
Well, when the match is at this particular stage and you're pretty much shut out, not much else you can do. Again, some serious velocity shooting that 10-pin.
Well, look, he is the 2010 reigning Australian Masters champion, so he's taken something very, very positive out of this year.
Lazy little $25,000 first prize.
Oh, if you don't mind. That's a kitty a lot of the bowlers in the field would love to take it home. Not to mention etching your name on that glorious trophy. Oh, sensational. What a piece of carry from Jason Walsh. He didn't think it was going to go. And after a stiff leave that Sam just left, tickled one out of the gutter.
Right now, Jason's just trying to keep his form up for his upcoming match. Worst thing he wants to do now is start throwing loose shots. Loses rhythm. He's out there just still trying to make the best shots he possibly can, give himself the best chance in his next match.
Get some belated carry there, Sam Cooley. No matter what, he's going to finish positively. He's got a good game going.
Strikes out for possible 248, which is a good game in anyone's language. Not going to be enough this time, though.
It will rue that that previous game where he opted to go for a different ball and wasn't getting a bit of carry, but look, it's one to put in the memory bank, isn't it? And next time you come up against something like this, you can always draw from that experience.
Every time you go out, it's a learning experience. When you stop learning, it's time to retire.
You know it all, Brenton. How come you haven't retired yet?
Well, I'm not going to make a comment that might sound make me sound like a big head or something, but I have to say at the moment, actually, the way my son's bowling might be hastening my retirement quite considerably. Lazy 264, 223 series from an 11-year-old. Give me a break.
You wait till I see him next. Or wait till he sees me next, yeah. Sorry.
That's a 247 for Sam Cooley. Great score in that game, but not going to be enough. Jason Walsh now is going to finish his match out. Try and finish it out positively. Keep his form and his rhythm up.
We're going to go down to Sam right now.
Sam, that was a really solid performance. For someone who's 19, I wish I was you. I was barely in puberty at 19. Here you are doing the things that you're doing. No shame in that. It was a brilliant game. So what are your thoughts on this? What are you going to take away from this and learn?
Well, I'm going to take away from this that I should really watch the signs when I can't carry, and I should learn to change ball when I need to.
Well, I'm sure I'll see plenty more of those green version shirts as you make more Australian teams. May, it's been a pleasure to watch you play, and we look forward to seeing you in the future. Well done.
Thanks.
Thanks for that, Dennis, and well done to Sam Cooley. A 438 over two games. Not too shabby at all, but boy, he ran into a buzzsaw today.
That he has.
Trying to continue the strikes, Jason Walsh. He's got plenty on the string now. That's five in a row. And gearing up for his next performance where he takes on Scott Robertson.
He's maintaining the intensity, maintaining his form. The worst thing that can happen is when you're a long way ahead, you start getting a bit lazy, lose your rhythm, lose your form. Odds on, you're going to lose the next match.
One more from Jason. Oh, you betcha. Nice and flush. He finishes with a 527 versus Sam Cooley's 438. Far too good. We'll be right down with Jason.
Well, congratulations there, Jason. That was a version in the last few weeks on the show. People are getting to know who you are. I know what you're about to tell me, but anyway, I'll ask it anyway. Well, how'd you do it?
At the start of that game, actually, I was a little bit worried. Sam started striking, and Sam's got a bit of a reputation around at the moment that when he starts striking, he doesn't stop. So, I was starting to think, but not making any mistakes. And luckily, I made a couple of little changes, and then the lane opened up again for me and threw some good shots from then on in. And, yeah, they all fell over. So.
Well, the future of our sport is bright with athletes like Sam having a ball. He pushed an absolute legend, and it's a pleasure to watch you play. We look forward to seeing you again next week with another up-and-comer. Well, now's the good part. Yeah. You again are the insurance advisor, Australia man of the match. So you get another check to add to your list. Again, fantastic result. Well done. And we look forward to seeing you again next week. Well, that's it for us for the 10-Pin Bowling Show for this week. Please join us again next week where you see another round with Jason taking on Scott Robinson. Thank you and good night.
The 10 Pin Bowling Show was proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.